You've probably heard a lot of discussion about Internet Explorer 8 now that it's been released to the public at last. Hi, I'm Nick Mediati, and I'm here to show you some of the great new features of IE8, starting with security. Microsoft Internet Explorer 8 features a number of new security features, such as phishing protection and private browsing. IE8's new improved phishing filter improves on IE7's filter with features such as more scrutiny of a web page's address. So if a web page says paypal.com or paypal.imascammer.com, it will be able to highlight that for you. It relies mostly on a database of known phishing sites, so some can slip through the cracks, but it's nice to have that protection there. IE8 displays domains in a darker color, so you can more readily see whether you're visiting a real ebay.com page or if it's someone faking it. IE8 also includes a new private browsing feature that Microsoft calls in private browsing. This is useful if, say, you're doing something on your computer you don't want someone to know about, like, oh, I don't know, buying a birthday present for a significant other. You can enable private browsing and it won't keep any track record of the sites you visited. So there have also been some new improvements to IE8's tab functionality. For example, if you open related tabs in Internet Explorer 8, the browser will group them together and color code them. So for example, if you go to pcworld.com and click a link and have it open up in a new tab, those two tabs will be color coded together and grouped together so that you can better organize what you're browsing. IE8 also has the capability to restore previous browsing sessions. So if you accidentally close the browser window, you can reopen it and open up all the pages you had opened before, which is a nice time saver, and it's a feature that's become common in most new web browsers like Safari and Firefox. Particularly handy new feature in IE8 is called accelerators, and the way these work is you would select a block of text and right-click them, and then you'll get a drop-down menu that gives you access to a number of different web services. These web services include things like translating text, looking up the selected text in a dictionary, or if it's an address, you can pull up a map for that location. IE8 also features improved web compatibility, which will make lives a little easier for those out there who make the web pages we use every day. But not all web pages are going to work properly with new web compatibility features, since there are a lot of older websites that may not work properly with IE8, Microsoft included a compatibility mode. Click a button in the toolbar and it'll display the page the same way that IE7 would. So those are just a few of the new features in IE8. I'm Nick Mediati. Thanks for watching.